Okay. We are looking at similarity. Remember, your host today is me as usual, Mr. Ishengoma. Now, we have a small exercise of two questions. When you look at number one, it is similarity by angle positioning. You can see one angle marked, it's there. Another angle marked, it's here. So our first job is to separate the two triangles, to identify the big triangle. And we said before, the big triangle is the triangle with the mark beginning from the outer line till the outer line. And that will take the value of 4, 7, x plus 5. And the smaller triangle is one of the inside one, but basically the one which contains the second marked angle. And it will contain y, 7 and 5. And then we say, we identify the corner which is being shared. And if you check properly, the shared corner is this one. After understanding the shared corner, then we go ahead to pair up the related sides. If this side is A, this one is small a. If this side is B, this one is small b. And if this side is C, this one is small c. Then we go ahead and work it out in pair. X plus 5 over 7, meaning a over a is equal to 7 over 5, meaning b over b is equal to 4 over y, meaning c over c. Now, because we have got a neutral fraction, then we shall use the neutral fraction to find x, and then we shall use it to find y. So here, we shall find x, and we shall do it by cross multiply. So 5 times x plus 5 is equal to 7 times 7. We shall get 5x plus 25 is equal to 49. 5x is equal to 49 minus 25. 49 minus 25, I get 24. Over 5, over 5, that is 24 divided by 5, it will give me x as 4.8. Then again, I take 7 over 5, 4 over y, I cross multiply, I get 7y is equal to 20 over 7 over 7. Hence, my y will be 20 divided by 7, and I will round it off to 2.86. That is how we handle question number one. Then we are going to proceed to question number two. If you look properly at question number two, you will realize that it is similarity by parallel sides. Similarity by parallel sides. As you can notice, the bigger triangle has the value 7, has the value 10, has the value 1. And the smaller triangle will have 4, 10 minus x, y minus 4. But as normal, once they are related by parallel, it means same side will be related by same side. And hence, We shall now have to pair up our fraction 10 over 10 minus x, y over y minus 4, 7 over 4. That is a over a, b over b, c over c. After doing that, then we have a neutral fraction which we shall use to find x, and again we shall use it to find y. So we shall cross multiply. We shall get 40, 7 times 10, 70, 7 times x minus 7x. We shall exchange. 7x will come this side and 40 will go the other side. When you subtract, we get 30. Then finally, x will be 30 divided by 7. So 30 divided by 7, it will take us to 4.29. Then we shall take the second part. That is y over y minus 4 is equal to 7 over 4. We shall cross multiply. 4y is equal to 7y, that is 7 times y, minus 7 times 4, that is 28. Then we shall exchange the position. 4y will come this side, 28 will come that side. So 28 is equal to 7y minus 4y. 28 is equal to 3y over 3 over 3. So 28 divided by 3, it will give me 9.33. This is how we solve this second question, that is by parallel sides. Thank you for watching. My name is Mr. Shengoma.